welcome back to my channel and to my new setup, which is my bed. I don't know, I figured I'd get good lighting here, so I'm pretty much just moving around everywhere in my room right now, so that's fun. I realise I haven't filmed a video in quite a long time. It's actually been 2 weeks since I haven't uploaded, and that's because I got sick, and then all my teachers in school were like, hey, I know what we're gonna do. We're going to make you hand in every single assignment, homework, coursework that you're ever going to do in this lesson before half term. And now it's half term, so I have every opportunity to try and film for you guys. But it will be getting a little bit more hectic as the months go on, because in the month of May, I will be doing exams. Meaning for everyone out there who isn't from England and doesn't do GCSEs, it's pretty much 20-something exams over a whole month that you have to take and study for constantly. So, bet you're glad you're not British now. Yay! By the way, if you're new here, hi, I'm Kate, also known as Chappers, which is my nickname. And if you like what you see, you like this video, you like my other videos, how about you stick around and click that subscribe button? Okay, I'm gonna stop with the cheesiness now because this is cringe-worthy. Let's just get into the video. I think I'm gonna do a voiceover today. I think I'm gonna do like this kind of setup. No. So I'm gonna try something new today. Not new to the market, but like new to me. it's been around for a while, but I haven't tried it out yet. But I wanted to buy a BB cream, right? Because I don't like really wearing foundation. If I do wear foundation, it's a light coverage. I don't really wear it on an everyday basis, but recently my skin has been hating me. So I'm going to be using a BB cream now. Long story short, I picked up this one. This is the Loriel Paris Nude Magique BB Cream. Universal Skin Perfector, 5-in-1, mimics the texture and glow of perfect bare skin, 24-hour hydration, and SPF 20. I got the shade in Ultra Light because I was swatching it in the store and it came out a little bit orange. So I figured I'd get Ultra Light so that I can just bronze up if it's too light. So yeah. It has smart pigment capsules, meaning it goes from white to coloured. Nice coverage. I think I'm gonna really like this because I prefer the coverage of a BB cream rather than anything else, right? Okay, let me zoom in. So I'm going to apply this to my skin. I don't know how this is best applied, but for now I guess I'll just it can work like that, right? That might have been too much though. It does smell like sun cream. Like, it really does smell sun cream. So, bear that in mind. If you don't like the smell of sun cream, you probably won't like this. That is strong sun cream smell. Hence the SPF 20. And even the ultra light is a little bit too dark for me. I'm not even that fair, so this is a little bit annoying. It's quite yellow. I have a very pink undertone to my skin, so this is, not so fun. The coverage is okay though. It covered all the redness on my skin. Well, apart from the spots, which won't leave me alone, like, at all. Why won't it go? I have a new product to try, and this is the NYX HD Studio Photogenic Concealer, as you can see, and this is in the shade Fair, which is CW02, and I got a really light one because the other one seemed a little bit too orange or, like, too pink. And even though I have a pinky undertone to my skin, it's not that pink. Like, it's more of a neutral skin tone. So I went with a lighter one that way that this way I can highlight under my eyes as well, but you already know what, we're just gonna roll with it. I need to lighten this foundation up anyway, so let's just see what I can do with this stuff. I'm gonna use my beauty blender just to blend it out. I'm gonna take that concealer over my eyes as well. It's very brightening. The color's not too bad. I think it matches my skin. I just don't like wearing foundation. I don't like the feel of heavy, like a heavy foundation feel. I like feeling very light and natural, so. But again, it's always down to personal preference. If you like a heavy coverage concealer, foundation, then you do you. I'm not gonna set my skin yet because I wanna kind of cream contour my skin today. I don't know, I feel like it, you know? So I'm going to use the Makeup Obsession Contouring Cream in light medium. Looks like this. Light medium, yeah. And no, it doesn't want to open. There we go. And I'm going to use a little foundation brush like this. This is the Real Techniques pointed foundation brush, and I'm just going to use this. This is quite a waxy texture, but it's really good. And I'm just going to contour and then blend with my beauty blender. I just want some nice cheekbone action today, and I think this is going to give me some nice cheekbones. I am going to bronze as well though, because I feel like bronzing. It's now spring, summer is almost here. Spring is definitely my favourite month of the year. Spring and autumn are my favourites, just because I like spring because all the colours and like it's all beautiful again and it's so much fun, and then it starts warming up. But you've still got rain and it's not too hot, because I don't like it too hot. And then autumn, when all the dark colours start coming. And obviously, it's my birthday then. And Halloween. And Halloween is the best. So yeah, I've cream contoured my skin. I think I'm ready to move on. In fact, actually, I want to clean up my contour a little bit with this concealer. Oh wow. You just heard that big smash on the floor? That was my brushes. Oh yes, then that is a chiseled cheekbone, my friends. I saw the other day that I now have 58 of you. 58 subscribers, and I know that doesn't sound a lot, but to me that's a lot, because I started this channel thinking I'll get like 5 subscribers, and now like, what, 6 months later, half a year, and I have 58, and I'm halfway to 100. Well, more than halfway to 100, I almost have 60, so if I can get 60 subscribers by the end of this month, and then 100 subscribers by the end of this year, I will be one happy bunny. Really happy bunny. Okay, so now I'm going to powder my skin, and I'm just going to be using my pressed powder from Collection, which is smashed. It's in the shade Candlelight. But yeah, it's smashed, so now it's a loose powder. Okay, right. I've got to be really careful with this because it goes everywhere. I'm just gonna just set my face with the powder. I'm even gonna go under the eyes and like over the eyelid. I think I'm good. Right. Yes. Now I'm going to actually continue on the face, and I'm going to bronze a bit using my NYC Smooth Skin Bronzing Face Powder in the shade Sunny, which is the perfect bronzer for me. It is slightly orange, but it's a really good bronze shade. So I'm going to use this new brush, which looks so white and beautiful and soft. It's the multitask face brush from Real Techniques. And I haven't had a chance to use it yet, so that's why I'm using it today. It's got a really cool angle to it, so that's really cool to like get in the hairline. Just gonna bronze. I'm gonna bronze under here. I haven't bronzed in a long time because I don't like bronzing in the winter. Personally, I like looking very peachy and blushy in the winter. I like changing with the seasons. Okay, I'm actually going back to my roots and I'm gonna use the Sleek Contour Kit, Face Contour Kit, in the shade Light, which looks like this, of course. So I'm just gonna take my contour shade. It's quite a dent in it now. And I'm just gonna go over where I cream contoured. That is a cheekbone. I'm really gonna have to blend that out. I'm just gonna buff it out with a buffing brush so that I don't look as crazy as I do right now. This isn't gonna be too much of a soft spring look. It's gonna be quite colorful as well, so, you know, bear that in mind. So yeah, contour is done. I am gonna apply eyebrows. Should we do eyebrows now? That's a good idea. I'm gonna be using the NYX eyebrow pencil in the shade Taupe, which is definitely not taupe. It is like really quite an orange shade. Like, how is that taupe? Taupe is meant to be quite grey and this is not grey. So still gonna use it. I need to use it up. Right, okay, let's zoom in. I need to prop you up on something else, but for now you can do just fine. I feel like this is gonna be way too warm tone for my brows. Look how warm tone that is. How is that taupe? This is taupe. This is not taupe. This is like straight up orange. And I didn't pick up the wrong one either. I can prove it to you. Look. Taupe. Do you see that? Probably not. But it says taupe. God dang it, NYX. Okay, so I've already done one eye, as you can see here. Just looks like that. Yep. So now I'm going to do this eye. I'm going to start with this eyeshadow from NYX in the shade Lol, which is an orange matte colour. There you go. And I'm just going to use a big fluffy brush and this colour to go into the crease with. Hello, Jensen. Well, hello to you too. I'm afraid you can't come near me though, because I'm filming. Oh, he just walked out again. Jensen, do you want to come have a cuddle? No, okay, love you too. I'm going to move on to the second shade, which is from Makeup Obsession. This is a lot of Makeup Obsession in this video today. I did not mean for it to be like that, but now that I'm looking at it, it is. And this colour, it's an eyeshadow from Makeup Obsession, and it's in the shade Precious Metal, which is just a beautiful bronzy colour. Like that. Which, I don't know why I'm swatching it for you, because I'm just going to go ahead and put this on my eye now. So, I'm going to take a flat shader brush, and I'm just going to... I keep knocking like the surface that the camera's propped up on, so I'm apologize for the shakiness. I'm just gonna take this Precious Metal on my finger and just really pat it out. To add a little bit more light to the center of my eye, I'm going to use this Barry M Dazzle Dust in the shade 39, which is a really pretty color. I felt like using a pigment because I never really use pigments, so I'm just gonna dip my brush in the pigment and then I'm gonna take a spray bottle of water and I'm just gonna give that a bit of a spray. This like really squirts it out. Ah, yeah, that like this. just to really, really bring some light to my eyes, because it's summer and spring. You want to look summery and springy. I'm going to take that lull shade again on the lower lash line, since I forgot to do that. I'm going to take Precious Metal, and I'm just going to go really close to the lash line. Now it is time for the eyeliner, and yes, this is a little bit tricky, but trust me, if I can do it, you can definitely do it too, because I suck at eyeliner. I'm going to be using the NYX Jumbo Eyepencil in Milk as a base. I wanted a quite a creamy base. Since I'm going to be doing this with eyeshadow, I really wanted it to be creamy, which is both a benefit and a curse. So I'm just going to take a little angled brush, and I'm just going to put it in the cream like this. And then I'm going to draw my wing. So let's try and match them up and hope for the best. I'm only taking it to about the center of my pupil, just because I like it better there. This is the hard bit. This is when you go into the crease. So just go in the crease, take your time, it's not a rush. And just draw your line. The hard bit is trying to get them even, so just take your time, be careful, keep switching between the eyes. I'm going to be taking this palette from H&M, which you can't get anymore, so I'm really apologize for that, but I really want this light blue shade. There are loads of colors like this anyway, but this is just what I'm using, this light blue kind of eggplant-ish shade. Why did I call it eggplant? How is that an eggplant? Using that on another eyeshadow brush, and I'm going to go over the white creamy area. And I'm just packing it on with the brush. I'm not worrying too much, because I'm going to clean. You can always clean it up as you go, so don't worry too much about it getting it really, really neat. It went a little bit too far up. I'm going to take Precious Metal and a very small little brush. And I'm just going to define and go over that blue where I don't want it. This way I get more of a defined line. Okay. Now I'm going to go in with the turquoise shade, this shade right here. And I'm going to go along the very outer edge of the line and then blend it slightly into the rest, just to make it a little bit more defined. I'm going to go over the top of that with the brush that I used for that light shade again. I'm now going to use two different pencils in my waterline, because I want to create like a halo effect in the waterline. So I'm going to start with the MUA Intense Color Eyeliner in the... Let's do that again. Starting with the MUA Intense Color Eyeliner in the shade Rich Brown, and I'm going to apply this on the outer edge of my waterline and the inner corner of my waterline. Just watch what I do and you will hopefully understand it eventually. So just going in. Are you still in frame? You are. Here in the outer corner, and then here on the inner corner. And now I'm taking the NYX Wonder Pencil in the shade Light, which is WP01, and I'm going to take this on the very center where we didn't apply the rich brown. I think what I'm going to do now is apply some mascara off camera, and then I will be right back. Okay, so the mascara that I used was the Soap and Glory Thick and Fast High Definition Collagen Mascara. Yeah. They're very thick and spidery, which I like. If you don't like it, then don't do it. But I like it, so that's what I did. Now we're going to go ahead and zoom out so that you guys can see the rest of the process. I'm going to start with blush. And for blush, I'm going to be using something a little bit more glowy. I'm using the Avon Diamond Shimmer Pearls, which are little pearls that are like blushies. Blushies. Swirl my brush and all the pearls, and all the little blushies. And I'm gonna apply this to my cheeks. So yeah, I'm just applying blush like my normal blush. And I've been experimenting with blush placement recently. Actually, yeah, let's just experiment some more. Let's put it right under my eye like I did in my Valentine video, which is in the corner of the screen right now. I believe it's this side, but knowing my luck, it's probably gonna be that side, so yeah. Do I wanna do freckles or not? Nada. Oh yes. I think I do. Little freckles on my skin. You can hear loads of talking downstairs. It's because the builders are back. We're getting this extension on the side of our house. So it's been very noisy around here recently. Can you even see the freckles? I can, but you may not be able to. There you go. Little freckles on my nose. If you don't like freckles, don't draw them on, but I think it makes the look really cute and summery, so I did freckles because I can. Okay, for the glow, I want a very springtime goldy champagne glow, so of course I'm going to use the classic Mary Luminizer from the Balm, and I'm going to apply this to my face because there's no other way that I could apply highlighter, really. I don't know any other way. I'm just going to use a brush and I'm going to hit the cheekbone. I mean, I don't want to apply too much because that blush is already pretty glowy itself, so I'm literally just going on top of that cheekbone very, very slightly. Because I don't really want to look like a grease ball, to be honest. Okay, so I'm going to be using the MAC lipstick in the shade Shy Girl all over my lips, and this is a cremesheen finish. You can't see the name of. Okay, Shy Girl. It's just a really pretty peachy peach color that I think will look really nice with this look. I'm just going to apply this to my lips. So guys, if you like this video, then make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you click subscribe and click the notification bell so you get notifications whenever I upload, which is usually on a Saturday every week. But who knows right now, because, well, it's hard when I'm studying, so yeah. But yeah, make sure you comment down below whether you like this video or not, and what other videos you would like to see from me. And yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Oh, I find myself so funny.
Everything's going flying.
Focus on me. Focus on me.
Whoa.